This is Bloomberg UTV.
This is Talkback. I'm Hindul Sengupta. For the first time on the show, an Olympic star no less, delighted to welcome on Talkback, Abhinav Bindra. Abhinav Bindra, thanks very much indeed for being on the show.
Thank you.
Let me then ask you, the big question that people want to ask in this country is, you have an Abhinav Bindra, most likely you will not get an Abhinav Bindra for many, many years once again. And you had to wait for many years to get one. The reason for that is that the structure of sport in this country is perhaps worse than it has ever been in its independent history.
There will be. We have tremendous amount of talent in India, and some of that talent will come to the fore and will win us medals. I think the most positive thing what has happened post the Olympics, when I won gold, there's been a huge change in the attitude of athletes. Earlier on, I mean, I've been to three Olympic Games, and you know, I've interacted with so many athletes. Whenever we went to an Olympic Games, it was just enough to be there, and to win any medal was just the biggest thing ever. If you win a bronze, it's unbelievable. But now, ever since Beijing, I mean, I've interacted with so many athletes, and now nobody talks about bronze and silver. Everybody wants the gold medal.
And the gold, many people, as you correctly point out, believe is not far away. But is the superstructure, is the infrastructure, is the mental infrastructure of sport in this country, apart from cricket, really gearing up for gold?
See, it's challenging. I'm not saying we're going to win the amount of medals which we should be winning.
But how many should we be winning?
A country like India with a billion plus population, if we had our a sports program running, if the Olympic Games were a priority like every other country puts them to be, we should be winning about 50 medals at the Olympics. We have the talent, there's no doubt about that. But we absolutely do not have any structure at the grassroots level to identify that talent and to nurture that talent, to take it from step to step by step, so that they climb the ladder and go from a district champion to an Olympic champion. I think it requires tremendous amount of investment. It requires tremendous amount of know-how. It requires infrastructure. It requires backing your athletes, and it requires a program where you have to be committed to, and results will not come instantly, but you have to keep working. You have to keep working. It's a process. Sports a process. Sports a risky business. I mean, there's absolutely no guarantee for success, but surely you can do all what you can to prepare for events, to prepare your athletes to the best of world standards, and then give it a good shot.
Let me ask you a blunt question then. You were lucky. You come from a prosperous family. Your father was able to give you all the facilities. You were able to build an international class shooting range within the confines of your home for you to nurture your talent. 99.99% of athletes in this country do not have that wherewithal. And therefore, they have to look at, you know, organizations like the state government or the union government or any other sort of club-level facilities for them to nurture their talent. That does not exist. And since it doesn't exist, apart from, of course, cricket, we're not talking about cricket, if it doesn't exist, why are you optimistic?
Well, I was lucky to an extent. That was my luck. That was my destiny. But yeah, certainly I'm optimistic because I see the talent. I see the hunger in the athletes, and I see their really single-minded devotion to do well for the country, and I see that passion, and I do believe that will come through. Presently, the government of India is supporting elite athletes. They've done more than they've ever done to support elite athletes. So, but elite athletes are very few in number. You have four or five, six elite athletes who would be medal potentials at London, for example. And those four or five, out of the four or five or ten athletes who are your stars, probably one or two will end up winning a medal. So I'm optimistic amongst that group. But I'm really talking about a larger picture. I'm talking about what really needs to be done. And what really needs to be done is focusing on our grassroots and focusing on the foundation of our grassroots.
Let me ask you then, for the longest time we were told in this country that this country doesn't have the money. We have other bigger issues. We have water and poverty and sanitation and drinking water and so on and so forth. And those problems remain today. But for the first time, perhaps in independent India, money clearly is not the problem. Money is not the problem. We have the money clearly. We clearly have the infrastructure in the sense that we know how to build it. So we have world-class companies who can build the infrastructure. That's not a problem. We clearly have the business acumen, as proved by the IPL. We know what to do with sport. It's not like we don't know how to sort of create value out of sport. And as you're pointing out, we have the talent. What then is missing?
Well, creating a business out of a sport, for example, the IPL is a bad example because an IPL was created out of a sport which was already successful, which was, it's always going to be harder to get other sports to that level, which are not so visible sports. But I really think you're absolutely right in saying that there's no problem about money. I think we have a good sports budget. Sports budget, I'm sure, will increase over the years. What we really need is focus. What we really need is a plan. And what we really need is the athletes coming first. I think the real goal of the sports policy should be, how do we produce 20 medals at the 2016 games, for example, or the 2020 games, and really have a project running to identify that talent right now and nurture that talent, back that talent for 8 to 10 years and give it a shot. Decisions linked to performance in sport need to be taken by experts who have enough knowledge in that respective field to make decisions on careers of athletes. Right now what is happening is people who are making decisions have never stepped onto a sports field.